Minnesota Gardeners, I'm Julie Weisenhorn with University of Minnesota Extension, and welcome to my pollinator-friendly landscape. We have hundreds of native bees in Minnesota, as well as our European honeybee. So it's important to have a lot of different diverse plants in your garden to feed lots of different kinds of bees. This bottle gentian, Gentiana andrewsii, is one of my favorite late season flowers. And here during the month of October, it's blooming, as you can see, bright blue in my garden. This particular flower requires the bumblebee, a big, strong bee, to be able to pry apart these petals and access the pollen and nectar in this plant. So looking around this landscape, you can see a lot of spent flowers. We have a few that are still blooming in October. But these flowers bloomed all throughout the summer and were provided nectar and pollen for different kinds of bees. The anise hyssop, Joe pieweed, ironweed, western sunflower. All of these were important food resources for our bees. In addition to a diversity of plants that serve as food for pollinators, we also want to create a really good habitat. And during the fall, it's important to think about that as you're cleaning up your yard. One of the ways is not to mulch everything in your yard. For example, underneath this area, this is a sandy, warm soil. It's got eastern sunlight in the morning, and ground nesting bees, solitary ground nesting bees, really like to build their nests in this part of my wall. Mulch can sometimes be very difficult for bees to get through to their ground nests. So in this area, the hostas cover up the soil, so I don't need to apply any mulch. One of the things that we do in our gardens in Minnesota is that we cut our plants back in the fall. And when you're thinking about pollinators, and particularly with stem nesting bees, it's a great idea to not cut your flowers back or your stems back as far as we normally would. Don't cut them to the ground. Cut them at about 18 to 20 inches. This happens to be swamp milkweed. This is a great pollinator plant. It's also a food source for monarchs. So I'm going to take this year's stems and cut them at about 18 to 20 inches high and just leave them like that. And you can see that the stems are hollow and bees will come down these stems and they'll lay their eggs in there. These are stems from last year that remained in place all year, and you can see how hollow they are. Those might very well make a good nesting space for some of our stem nesting bees. So what do you do with the stems that actually do fall down and are lying in your garden? Some people like to tidy that up a little bit more. What I do is I'll pick them up and I'll put them into a bundle like this, and I'll just tuck this kind of in an out-of-the-way place in my garden where you can't really see it, but it still leaves them available for any stem nesting bees. Some of these might already have eggs laid in them anyway, so I don't want to destroy them by composting or burning them. So I'm going to just tuck them under my spruce tree here. So in addition to bundling up the sticks in your yard, you can also make a bee house. And you want to do that by cutting hollow tubes, hollow sticks like this, and cut them into between 5 or 8 inches long. And then you're going to insert them into some kind of a holder. It could be a piece of PVC. I'm using an old flower pot here. And I'm going to put a piece of plastic in the bottom because there's still holes in the back, and we want to prevent any kind of parasites or pathogens from sneaking in here and using these tubes for their own nests. Then I'm just going to put in my sticks. These are stems from hosta, Joe pieweed, echinacea, monarda, all different kinds. And you can see that they're all different sizes. Those are for different sizes of bees. So another important part of habitat for pollinators, and when we're cleaning up our yards in the fall, is you don't have to be quite as tidy as we've been in the past. In fact, we found that leaf litter left on soil is really a great place for our beneficial insects to spend the winters. So in the case of this big root geranium and catmint and hostas and all these plants that are ornamental, I'm not going to clean up all these leaves in here. I'm going to leave them down here and let them act as a natural mulch. They'll break down on my soil in the spring, and they'll also provide that habitat for our important pollinators. So as you're cleaning up your fall landscapes this year, think about our pollinators and what you can do now to help them through the winter and in the spring. Leaving stems standing, cut them at 18 inches. Collect dead stems that have fallen and put them in a location where they can be found by the bees. Create bee houses and leave that all-important leaf litter on your soil. I'm Julie Weisenhorn from University of Minnesota Extension, and this is my pollinator-friendly landscape. For more information, visit extension.umn.edu and go to our yard and garden page.